gets what he deserves.
The first politician to go down in the sweeping federal corruption probe is former state senator Martin Sandoval.
Again, I am deeply ashamed of my actions. I take full responsibility. I apologize to the people of Illinois and, most importantly, the constituents.
Today, he pleaded guilty to two felony charges, bribery and lying on his tax returns. He's facing between 10 and 13 years in prison, though he could get less time if he tells investigators what he knows.
Mr. Sandoval has been cooperating. To the extent of his cooperation or what he's done, I'm not going to get into detail on that.
Prosecutors detail conversations he had at a restaurant in Burr Ridge with a representative from a red light camera company.
Mr. Sandoval admitted to accepting over $250,000 in bribes.
He wanted even more money if he was going to protect their interests, saying, quote, "Why don't I get that offer? It galls me to know, but because we've established such a great relationship, because you know I'll go balls to the wall for anything you ask me, it's hard for me to swallow how people make so much off of you, right? And I got to do the work." When they asked him how much he needed to be paid, he said, "I can't say. It would have to come from you. That's just not my style." The representative said, "Just off the top of your head, what pops into your head?" He came up with $5,000 a month to protect the company against red light camera legislation that could have cost them business. He went on to say, "But how would we do that? So how many companies do you have? Do you have a baloney company or something innocuous?" He's the fourth Illinois politician to face charges since last January.
It's a very stubborn problem we seem to have here in Illinois.
Last fall, federal agents raided his home and offices. He then resigned from the state Senate. The corruption investigation is apparently focused in part on Safe Speed LLC, one of the largest red light camera operators in the state. Though they are not named in court documents, Sandoval said the name today aloud in court.
Every person that was mentioned or referenced in the Sandoval search warrant, whether by name or by letter or by number, should be very concerned about their future. But people should be nervous.
So Sandoval was allowed to walk out of court today. He's on a $10,000 unsecured bond, which means he didn't actually have to post any money. His case is not up again until July. That's just for a status hearing. He doesn't even have to be here for that. It looks like he's not going to be sentenced for a very long time. It could be even a year here because investigators want to make sure they have all the time in the world to talk to him. A reporter today did ask the U.S. attorney, "Is the speaker, Mike Madigan, getting caught up in all of this?" He refused to comment.